from team 17386, the Cubed Ets, and this is our robot. We will be going over how to download the newest app updates and versions for the control hub and for a driver station phone. The things you will need for this video is a USB-C cord to connect to the control hub, a computer, and your robot for the control hub. For doing the Android phone, you'll need whatever cord you need to connect to the computer with, so you can connect and download. So we're gonna start with the control hub. So first things first, if you don't already have it, you will need to download the REV hardware client that is right here. Looks like this. We'll post a link to the site where you can download it from in the description below. So once you're there, and it's downloaded, you need to get out of the app so you can connect the control hub to the computer. And when doing it, make sure your robot is on so it can actually display the control hub. Once you do that, open up the REV hardware client, and you should get to a screen where it shows what it is sensing. This here shows the control hub and the expansion hub. So once you get there, go into the, if you're wanting to update the control hub, you click control hub, and it gives you a nice screen on the right. And from there, you can get to the control hub operating system. Right now, we are currently at the latest version, 1.1.2. If you haven't done anything to the control hub and just barely got it, you're most likely at 1.1.1. So you'll want to update to the latest version. And from there, whatever version you want, you click it, and then you hit what will be an install or downgrade button if you wanted to downgrade, which I don't recommend. The robot controller app, you can also update to the latest version, but it does give a clear warning that if you are using the Android Studio to put all your op modes and code for it, you'll want to update through Android Studio and get the latest from the GitHub repository and things that way to update the app, or you can do in here, but then you'll also have to update the Android Studio, and that's just a lot more work. And if you want to update your hub firmware, you can also find it right here in your control hub things. If you are still needing to do other things such as figure out what it's connected to or rename it, you can go into here. Then there should be an edit button, manage button, where you can go in and put in, if you need to rename it, you can rename it. You can put in a password because you have to change the password. Any of that other stuff you might need, you can do on here. So, yeah. Then if you need your expansion hub stuff updated, you can do it here. And it will tell you if it needs to be updated. And you have to connect straight to the expansion hub. We are not currently, so we can't. To install stuff for the phone, first of all, the first thing you want to do is come get into the settings onto your phone on the Android device. You'll want to go into about the phone, and you want to make sure, if you are not a developer, that you get developer. And to do that, you'll want to hit build number 7 times, and it'll let you know. Once you're a developer, you'll see this called developer options. You want to go into there and make sure your USB debugging is turned on. Because if not, so you want to make sure it's okay. If not, it will not properly, when you connect it to the computer, you won't be able to actually do much of anything. So next step is you want to connect it to the computer or whatever thing you have the REV hardware client installed on. So you'll connect it. If it is a Motorola phone, you might have to, or Android phone, you might have to make sure you change it to transfer files, not just charging the device, or else it won't do anything to the phone. Then you'll go into the REV hardware client, and it should hopefully bring up your phone. Once it's brought up the phone, you want to double click on it. And this one currently has a Jarvis Station app already installed, so we can just update it when there's new updates that way. If it didn't have any of these installed, it would have both the Jarvis Station app and the robot controller app, and it would give you the option to you'd have to download one of them. And you'll download one. Once it downloads, it will give you the option to install. You'll install, and it will install to the most up-to-date version there is. And then you'll see a screen similar to this, most likely with a driver station app. And you can also convert the device to a robot controller if needed, and that's also more useful if you are using two phones instead of a control hub and a phone. And that is how you update and install the latest versions of the apps to your phone.